So it's one thing to say that our project builds successfully, but how do we know that it works right? The best answer that software engineering has come up with for this is to use a lot of different kinds of tests. Now, testing is a huge subject, and we actually have a whole course on it. But let's take a quick look at some different kinds of tests. Unit tests are tests that developers write alongside the application code. Each test checks the behavior of one specific unit of code, like a function or class. They're designed to be automated. Developers will run them repeatedly as part of the development process. Regression tests, on the other hand, get written as part of debugging and troubleshooting. Once you've fixed a bug, you want to make sure that it doesn't come back due to some future oversight, a regression. So you add a test that checks specifically for that particular bug. Like unit tests, regression tests are automated and run frequently. A smoke test is something that gets run after the build, kind of a sanity check to make sure the system basically works before doing any more refined testing. For instance, if our project is a web server, we might just bring a server instance up and fetch the homepage just to make sure it doesn't crash. The term smoke test comes from electrical engineering. You can imagine plugging an appliance or a machine in and seeing if it catches fire. But it also has an older meaning in plumbing, as a test for newly installed pipes. Before putting water in a pipe, plumbers would fill it with pressurized smoke to see if the smoke leaked out anywhere. A system integration test is just a little bigger. It's a test of the system including not just our code, but also the backends and dependencies and data that our code makes use of. You might often run it on dedicated test machines. But when we treat infrastructure as code, we can spin up test instances as VMs dynamically when we need to. In doing that, we'll test our deployment scripts too. An automated acceptance test is something that you'd write to verify that a system or feature does what the user wants it to. Now, it can't replace everything that a human QA tester might do, but there are testing frameworks that let you automate quite a lot, whole workflows, clicking buttons, filling out data fields, whatever a user might do in your app. And then, depending on your service, you might have a manual QA step as well before a launch goes to production. If that's the last step before launch, the QA tester's approval can actually tell the continuous deployment system that it's okay to go ahead with the rollout. So there we have six different kinds of testing: unit testing, regression testing, smoke testing, system integration testing, and automated and manual acceptance testing. But while we're talking about testing, let's talk about bugs too. Having a single unified bug tracking system can go a long way toward improving communication amongst teams. If it's accessible to everyone in the organization to report issues and collaborate on fixing them, then that's one less barrier to getting real work done.